Kieran Allen, anti-for-profit alliance and social worker in Ireland. I would agree completely with Francis Ostabado when he says that the issue of the radical left is about nothing less than the reorganisation of working class politics. I think that the experience of millions of working class people across Europe is betrayal and disgust at the failures of Stalinism, the failures of social democracy. In the case of Ireland, the sort of collapse of republicanism from an organisation that was once associated with robbing banks, now offering state support to banks. And it's this space that I think the radical left has to occupy. And I think that for us, empirically, that has emerged from an experience that as revolutionaries, we have been involved in leading many, many campaigns in Ireland, but we have found that of the tens of thousands of people in those campaigns, very few join a revolutionary organisation. Therefore, it has been necessary to create a space between the revolutionaries and people who are often moving from a left reformist background into questioning the system. The 2 points I want to make really just in terms of our experience is this. Number one, we spent many, many years talking to almost everybody on the radical left that existed on the radical left, and we got nowhere. We talked to the leadership of almost every single organisation in Ireland, and that did not help us in terms of breakthrough with the People Cross Line. We are still part of those discussions, and we will continue those discussions. But what I want to argue is, the element that brings about change is the ability to create facts on the ground. If you can apply the United Front method to every struggle in working class areas to actually ensure that revolutionaries are working with, in a political force, with left reformists to lead real struggles, whether it's on bin charges, working class strikes, fights against racism or war, it is that fact alone that creates the radical left. And we found a very interesting thing during the election. Where our candidates got 2% of the vote, people said to them, we agree with your programme, but we've never seen you before. When we got 10%, 12% of the vote, it is where people said, we agree with your programme, and you're the people who've led this struggle and that struggle and so on. So therefore I want to say, the emergence of radical left will come from the top, and it will also come from the bottom. And the last point I want to make is this. The development of radical left, I agree completely with Francois. The issue of no participation in a bourgeois government when it's led by the Social Democrats, or obviously the right wing, absolutely. But for us, there's also something more to the construction of a revolutionary Marxist current. There are a whole number of issues that confront you in the radical left, whether it's issues to do with Palestine, whether it's issues to do, for example, in our situation, with loyalism, orange Marxism, or whether, for example, this Saturday, a march on abortion. All sorts of debate emerge in the radical left. So therefore, for us, it's absolutely clear we want a broad, radical alliance, and we want to be open, and we are open with our allies. We are maintaining and will not be dissolving a revolutionary Marxist current inside that alliance.